This video is proudly brought to you by Hovatek. Hovatek. Just a button away.
In this tutorial, I'll be explaining how to set up or install ADB and Fastboot, including their drivers. Now, I won't go down to breaking down what ADB and Fastboot are for, but basically they are command line tools which are very useful when you want to tweak or modify anything in an Android phone. Just look up what ADB and Fastboot are for. Alright, so what we'll be needing for this basically is just the installer. I'll be using the installer method. This is a manual method you could use, but to make it easier for you to set up, I'll be using an installer method. Now what you need to do is to first download the ADB setup installer. Now the link to this is at the description, so just check out the description part of this video tutorial. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is to run as administrator in case you run into some privilege issues. Alright, click yes. Alright, so here's the, let me drag it down here. So here's the setup. Now this is a very quick installer, so it's nothing difficult. Now for this part it says, do you want to install ADB and Fastboot? I want here, so I just tap my Y key and I press enter. Now next option is install ADB system wide. Now what this means is, do you want to install ADB for all users that is on the C drive, or want to install ADB for a particular user, which is going to be C drive users, then that particular user. Now I want to install it system wide in this case. That means anybody can access ADB. He or she just has to go to my C drive to use ADB. So I leave it as system wide yes here and enter. Now I just give it time to install. Now it's done installing, as you can see here. It'll be available to install system wide. Now it's asking me, do you want to install device drivers? Now these drivers are basically your Android USB drivers, which is going to help your PC communicate with your phone when connected via USB cord. Of course you don't want to install these drivers, so I just select Y yes here and enter. Now a wizard pops up. All you need to do in this wizard interface is just click next and we are done. Alright, so now I want to be sure my ADB is all set up. So what you do is go to the C drive, you can see the ADB folder here in C drive since I selected system wide. So ADB, I open it. Now to launch ADB, you see if you double click this, alright, all you get is something like this, which is what most people do. You're not supposed to double click that. This is not, even if you try to run an administrator, you're still going to get the same. Okay, maybe you get a prompt, then you're going to get this. This is not how you run ADB or Fastboot. Now to run it, what you need to do is to look at your keyboard that's on your laptop or your desktop PC. You hold down the shift button. Now I'm holding down my shift button as I'm speaking, so my shift button is being pressed down. Now while holding down your shift button, you right click on, okay, sorry, you need to unselect. If you're highlighting any item like this, it's going to give you an issue. So what you want to do is click on this empty space here, so nothing's highlighted. Highlighted is blue. Can you see the difference? Not highlighted is just a white box. Alright, so what you want to do is to click on any empty space so it's not highlighted. Now after clicking this, you hold down your shift as I'm doing right now. Now while holding down shift, you right click. Now from the menu here, you can release your shift at this point. From the menu here, you just click open command window here. So once you click open command window here, you have your command line interface. So from here, I can test. Okay, I have my phone connected to the PC. Let me reconnect it to be sure. Alright. So I have my phone connected to the PC. So to test that my ADB is working, I just type ADB devices and I press enter. Alright, so my device is detected, so that means my ADB is all set up. I could go ahead to test my fastboot. So I boot into fastboot mode with my phone connected. So ADB reboot, bootloader. Don't forget the space between ADB reboot and bootloader is very important. So I press enter. So what this is basically going to do is to boot my phone into fastboot. So once the phone is in fastboot, I am practically good to go on my fastboot command. Alright, my phone is in fastboot. I can see fastboot here. So let me test fastboot. Since my phone is in fastboot mode, I would have loved to show you a shot, but basically what I have here on my phone is just fastboot, then fastboot mode dot 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 at the bottom with a blank screen. So that is my fastboot mode. So I'll run a fastboot command to be sure my fastboot is also working. So I say fastboot devices. Alright, so my device is detected. So basically that's how to set up ADB and fastboot on your Windows PC.